What is going on, guys? It is OggiEx, and we are back on Rise of the Tomb Raider. Now, why are we back playing this game? We already finished it. Well, I decided it would be wrong of me not to come back and play some of the new DLC stuff that they've been putting out. When I say new, Rise of the Tomb Raider has been out for a while, and I've not really come around to play it. But if I could do a full playthrough of the actual story, I think it would be good if I actually play through some of the new expansion modes, a new Blood Ties story that takes place in Croft Manor and things apparently. And this all came out for 20th anniversary of Tomb Raider, I believe, around that time, but 20 years of Tomb Raider. That's good. But anyway, let's get into it. Now, I have no idea what I'm planning to do, because there is so much, like, this never used to be here. We've got an option on the menu now that says, on the menu now, that says Croft Manor. So we could go to Croft Manor for a new Blood Ties story mode, I believe, and Lara's Nightmare Expedition, which should be interesting, because I hear that is a survival-based thing against zombies in Croft Manor. Now, that is definitely going to be good. I really want to play that. But I'm tempted to play Blood Ties first, because it's a new story. So I might just jump in and play this. No idea what I'm getting myself into. So let's have a look what this is about.
Final notice to Lara Croft, a current tenant of premises. This is to serve as your final notice for the purposes of terminating your ownership of Croft Manor. You are required to immediately vacate and surrender possession of said manor to Atlas de Mornay, executor of estates.
Lara, it is unfortunate that you have forced my hand in this matter, but so be it. As you know, your parents appointed me executor of the estate in the event of their absence. Since your mother disappeared, her death was never technically declared, and given the circumstances surrounding your father's death, it's no surprise that he never drafted a formal last will and testament to account for this circumstance. Unfortunately, you have no legal claims to the estate. I'm willing to negotiate a modest monthly stipend from your trust, but only if you leave the manor by week's end. Don't fight me on this, Lara. Your mother wouldn't want that. Sincerely, Atlas.
There has to be a will or some kind of evidence of what happened to Mum in the manor somewhere.
Okay, so
that's safe.
We gotta look around the manor to try and get hold of a will to testify against Croft. Against losing Croft Manor, I get it. But can I just say, it feels so weird to be back. I'm trying to get my gist of the controls all over again. It's so good to be back. It would be wrong for me not to play through this stuff.
My birthday crown. I was so proud of that thing.
Wearing an Egyptian crown. Is there anything written on it?
That's my handwriting. My penmanship was pretty good.
Penmanship. So there's a lot of nostalgia and memory in this place. Is that pretty much what this is going to be? It's just going to be full of like memories from past experiences throughout all the 20 years of Tomb Raider, because it is the 20th anniversary. See, look at this. We're finding all this stuff here.
A picture with Dad and Anna. Never liked wearing dresses, but the color was nice.
Blue. Certain shade of blue. Picture with Anna. Anna. Nobody liked Anna. Anna was a bitch.
Dad would have liked me to go to Oxford, but I insisted on UCL. Yep. Looks real. Roth once offered to forge me a fake diploma to show Dad.
Roth. Is it... Roth was the guy from the first... game. Let's just explore Croft Manor a little bit here.
This is the map I made for my first expedition with Dad. It shows a path to the library through the servants' passages.
Servants' passages. Wow, servants' passages. Okay, I'm guessing that's a map we have to follow. Hold up.
Too dark. Going to need a flashlight.
I can see in there. Oh, okay, I saw it. Never mind, it is pretty dark in there. Let's have a look around here.
Well, hello there, Sir Lancelot. Don't worry, I won't be boring your sword this time.
That's a call out to Legends right there. That is a straight up reference to Tomb Raider Legend. Sir Lancelot, the King Arthur's Knight, and the Excalibur. That is a straight up shout out to that. Straight up reference.
The Grand Hall. Always loved playing in here as a kid. This will be one of the first things to fix.
Whoa. Why is this place in ruin? I mean, this doesn't take place after the events of Underworld.
Lara, you know the West Wing is off limits.
I'm sorry, I just wanted to see.
We've been through this.
Was Mum's room in here?
Just stay out of there, darling.
So
that was always so protective of the West Wing.
What are you doing sitting there on the floor, Mistress Lara?
Looking at the compass, thinking.
What about, if I may inquire?
Just thinking about discovering faraway places, about finding adventure.
I'm sure you will, my lady.
The offer came in the post last week, and I still haven't told Richard. He flew ahead to Tibet, where I will meet him shortly.
One of her dreams.
I never told him I was
so
submitting
cruel.
My work. Never thought there was a chance of being accepted. Oh, but a gallery tour is not something I can pass up. The show will take me away from England for over a year. I'll begin in New York and travel across the United States and... Oh, God! I'm giddy even writing these words. When Richard and I were married, I was prepared to relegate my painting to a hobby. But it was Richard who objected, who gave me my atelier and studio. Without that support, I'm...
Just like through the actual game itself when I played it, if you want to read this stuff, pause
it. The soul of an explorer.
I normally get this stuff a read over when I edit anyway, so. Plus, I can always come back to the game before I want to. Alright, let's have a look around here. Why are all these doors locked? Okay. Can't go in the West Wing either. This is closed off.
Need a key to open this.
Force it be locked. Right. Why is everything in this place locked?
This belongs to Anna. Most of her belongings are in the guest house. What was she doing in here? Someone has a sense of humor.
Oh, yeah. I read it. I see it. Okay, right. The only way I can see we can go is through that servant's passage. Now, it's just a case of finding a torch or a flashlight of some kind that we can use. Where would you keep it? Oh, hang on.
Got to remember to pack this for my next trip.
Aha! It's a flashlight. Nice.
Should be able to explore the dark now.
Nice. And this. Oh.
Hey, Jonah. Sorry for not getting back to you sooner. I've decided to do some research at the manor. A lot has happened, and I need some time to think about what I want to do next. This old place is filled with memories and secrets. Uncle Atlas has tried to keep me out of here for so long, I don't even know if I want to keep it. But after everything that's happened, maybe I can find out what it still means to me. If it's worth fighting him for. I'll let you know how things worked out when I'm back in London.
So, she's pretty much been in a position where she's always been at risk of losing the manor since her father's death. Or is it because she's been too busy going off on these adventures? It's still giving me this frame problem every time I go into a new area.
Amelia, the news has reached Mother. She knows that you broke off your engagement with the Earl of Farringdon. She is beside herself with worry. But, for the moment, she's controlling the narrative. As far as anyone knows, you're just having innocent second thoughts. But the moment your affair with Lord Croft goes public, it will be too late. Our name will be as ruined as this man you've chosen to bed. Don't you see that you're being selfish, Amelia? Please, consider your family. You're a de Mornay. Everything you do has a greater effect on us all. I'm coming down to London soon. Don't do anything rash until we have a chance to talk.
I like how we're getting this backstory filled in about her parents. This manor is full of secrets. Oh, did I just put my foot through the stairs?
Falling apart. Maybe I should just let my uncle have this place.
Okay, wait a minute. What's this? Full of history. Let's see.
They say a good test of a relationship is how well you travel together. Well, I'd say Amelia and I have passed that test with flying colors. Indeed, these last few months in Egypt have been nothing short of extraordinary. She and Roth get on like old uni chums. In fact, the two have spent more than a few nights drinking and playing cards into the wee hours. Despite her decidedly proper upbringing, Amelia's taken to roughing it more than I ever have. She fits in and connects with the local populace with such amazing empathy. Because of her, I've had a bit of an unexpected breakthrough in my research. She managed to convince an artifact dealer in Old Town to sell me a magnificent and quite unusual Tibetan scroll. From what I can tell, it...
Okay.
I'm not surprised he asked her to marry him as soon as he got the idea.
Locked again. Great. Master key. Everything requires the master key. Alright, the servant's passage. We're gonna have to go down here. Right, one sec.
Shut up, Sandy!
Fucking annoying dog.
Amelia, I know we have had our differences in recent years. I've tried my best to keep an open mind about your relationship with Richard, but I just can't let you go on this ill-conceived expedition without saying my piece. You say Richard's theories have merit. You say that he may have actually stumbled upon some mythic, unknown truth, but I have seen nothing to support such claims. And while your word may have been enough in times past, I cannot let you squander away what remains of your name and reputation and that of our family, truth be told, on some damned foolish crusade. I intend to go to Richard's investors and let them know exactly how he's spending their money, but I want to give you a chance to put a stop to this yourself. Please, don't go to Tibet. If not for me, at least for Lara.
Okay.
Still just as creepy as I remember.
Was that a shiver, Lara? Didn't think you'd be scared of your own home, but if you've got memories here, then that all makes sense, I guess. Ooh,
King
me,
to Queen
hiccups.
One. I'm going to win this time, Winston.
Clever girl. But you Jesus. Know by now, winning...
I would play chess with our old butler Winston on this board. Never could beat him. I always chose white. Maybe if I let him go first once in a while, I might have won.
Isn't everything? Queen to King's Bishop 6. Check.
Easy for you to say. You always win. Knight takes queen.
What I mean to say is try to enjoy the journey, Lara. Don't rush to victory. Bishop to King 7.
Right, okay. Oh. Something else here?
Everything is almost ready for Mistress Lara's birthday expedition surprise. It's been a bit of an all-hands-on-deck effort organizing the affair and keeping it secret.
Hmm.
She's obsessed with Egypt, memorizing hieroglyphs and ancient Egyptian districts, so she'll be delighted with what Lord Croft has come up with.
Well, that's nice. So even as a child, Lara was very ambitious. Okay, it looks like I need to clear the path there, so... I guess I'll go back here. Look at it. Right, and I'll pull this across. And then that should be unblocked. Nice. Let's get to it.
Dad, this is it! The basement of despair!
Indeed, Lara. Muster your courage, for this is the only path to the Library of Infinite Knowledge.
Look there! See the string?
An ancient Egyptian tripwire. The keepers of knowledge want none to disturb their treasures. We must tread carefully.
Let me lead. I know how to spot all the traps.
I'm sure you do, my darling. Lead on!
So, Lara as a child was very ambitious, and her father... pretty much encouraged her to do what she does. It's nice to know that her family really supported her last year. She would have gone with. Oh, what's this?
One of the wire traps Winston made for my birthday expedition.
Is that going to fall on me?
Water damage from the main hall above.
What the hell happened here to this manor? Why is it in bits? There we go. Anything useful in here? Okay. Requires a crowbar.
Plans for adding electricity to the manor. Dad used to say his granny hated all the bright lights. There's a missing page.
Is that something? That's probably something we need to keep an eye out for.
Amelia left tonight. She packed her suitcase and walked right out of here, and I didn't even notice. Like those days in the Oxford Library before we even met, I just had my nose in a book, lost in my own world. I am such a fool. I have let my obsession with this damned ritual of long life rule my better judgment for far too long, and it may already be too late. How could I have not seen this coming? I've made this mistake over and over, always putting my research before my personal life. But it's never hurt like this before. I simply cannot live without her. If I have to give up this accursed quest that has plagued me for so long, then so be it. I am going after her, right now, tonight.
Whoa. Okay.
Okay, Dad's ledger has to be in here somewhere.
Hopefully
it has the combination to the safe. Took quite a tumble off of this old thing when I was a girl. Still feel it in the shoulder from time to time.
Let's go and have a look. Thank you. It would have been a very cheating way of getting around. Oh, we'll just do it that way. That works. Pro skills. Yay.
Blank, except for the image of a key. I remember this map now. It leads to the master key. But we made it with a special kind of invisible ink. It could only be seen with the heat of a fire.
That was a heater.
I think I stashed one of Winston's master keys in here when I was a kid.
Let's have a look around the study a little bit. What
have you got? I've reached the monastery. As Roth predicted, it was hidden deep in the Himalayas. And now that I'm standing on these high stone walls, I am overwhelmed by the sheer beauty of the mountains that surround me. It is simply breathtaking. But what adds to their spiritual majesty is the truth of this place. The monks welcomed me, as is their way, but they seemed to expect me. They must have known someone like me would eventually come seeking answers. I know this is the place. They've...
Dad was looking for an elixir. Was it the elixir of life? I remember this now. Each district in ancient Egypt had a symbol and a number. I always preferred these symbols to the actual number hieroglyphs.
This is how you told them apart? Is this something we're going to have to memorize?
No, let me see. These two myths are referencing the same source material. But where did I see this image?
Dad, I think it's this one. In the chapter on Egyptian districts.
Why, yes, I think you're right, Lara.
I remember the page with the illustration of Ra.
My goodness.
This was always one of my favorite books in this library. I used to trace hieroglyphs.
Paying attention, haven't you? This could be an important breakthrough.
Does this mean I'm your research assistant?
Anything I could use? Come on, anything at all. Play some music.
This music is familiar. It's beautiful.
Hang on. I have heard this before. I'm pretty sure this song was in one of the classical Tomb Raider games. Yeah, it is. It is.
It appears Sir Reginald's helmet fell off. Or didn't I put it back properly?
For God's sake, memorize the combination, you fool. Lara's expedition treasure. My favorite painting by Amelia. The day of our wedding anniversary.
So I'm guessing it's a free combination. On the lock to the safe. Remember the combination. Okay, so Lara's treasure, Amelia's painting, wedding anniversary. Okay, gotta remember those.
Okay, got to find those objects to figure out the combination to the safe. There's something else here.
Ooh. Open it.
Dad's lighter. I don't remember him ever using it, though. The Croft family crest and initials PC. I wonder if this belonged to my grandfather.
So can I use it on this? Okay. The lighter is obviously of some importance.
Okay. Should be able to light the fireplace now. This should help me read the map.
Okay. Let's read this.
I can see the map. Looks like the key is hidden under a trunk near the bookcase.
Right, under a trunk near the bookcase. Okay, so the fire, the two C's. Tr- trunk.
X marks the spot, as they say.
Trunk and a bookcase. You mean here? Aha! Nice. This is really clever.
A master key. This should get me into the West Wing.
Oh, camera kind of fell a little bit. Alright, now we've got the master key. Nice. We're getting somewhere. We are getting
somewhere. This should open most rooms in the manor, including the forbidden West Wing.
Right, can I open this now? What do we have?
The Pharaoh's crown from my birthday treasure hunt. How old was I again? 6? 8? I think this hieroglyph corresponds to a number. But which one?
I'm getting it now. Treasure. The Pharaoh's crown. That would be Lara's treasure. The two owls. Hieroglyph
Here we go. Each district in ancient Egypt had a symbol and a number.
Five.
I always preferred these symbols to the actual.
Right, it was 5. Okay, well now I know that the first digit was 5. And now the West Wing. We go into the West Wing. Open the sesame.
Worse than I thought.
Whoa.
This is strangely beautiful.
Place isn't giving me the shivers at all. What have we got here?
My lord, we all hope your work was well received at the conference and look forward to your return. As is so often the case with these missives, I wanted to call your attention to an incident involving our little angel. It seems that Lara has been the subject of some ridicule amongst the other girls at school. From what I can gather, some of the other young ladies were teasing her for being too much of a tomboy. You know how Lara can get when pushed into a corner. Let's just say they won't be bothering her again. But I do think their words have had an effect.
Untouched for years, exactly as you left it.
Room for the paintings, right?
I stood up to my family's criticism, stood in defense of Richard and our love. But as my new life began in Croft Manor, doubt set in. How could love flourish in these cavernous halls and endless passageways? Had I made a terrible mistake? I have never been more delighted to be wrong. Richard welcomed me to the manor, my new home, with a game. It was a clue, written in jumbled words from five different languages, but it pointed the way forward. The next clue was a seemingly blank piece of parchment in the kitchen, where the heat of a candle revealed a message written in lemon juice. I followed each step, grinning like a child as I solved his riddles and chased the trail to its end. A white cloth stretched out on the lawn where a picnic was laid out. We laughed and ate, and my doubt vanished.
Okay. Favorite painting.
Mum's paintings. Which one was Dad's favorite?
Try and figure this out.
I returned home this afternoon to collect the last of my paintings. I suppose I should say I returned to my family's home. Atlas was there, in one of his foul moods. And even as he dripped venom for Richard with his cruel barbs, I could only laugh. To think that I once listened to my bitter brother in matters of my own happiness. My dismissal only served to infuriate him more. I left him there in Father's study, muttering to himself. On the drive back, as Winston took a longer route through the country, I looked through my paintings, Richard's favourite one among them, a simple abstract with blocks of red.
I smiled,
thinking about giving it to him. I was happy, and...
So it's...
Blocks of red, Dad's favourite painting. Maybe something about that painting will help me figure out the combination.
blocks of red. Do I count the blocks of red? In which case it'd be 4, so it would be 5-4. 5-4, is it? I have no idea. Anything else? Another entry.
Lara arrived tonight, though not without a bit of drama, but all is well. She's a healthy, beautiful baby. I've never seen Richard so happy. I'm sure he'll be celebrating with his favourite whiskey tonight.
Lara's
birth.
It's
calm and peaceful now. Just the gentle sound of the rain and the small, sleeping breaths of this new life I hold in my arms. Lara, Lara Croft, my darling daughter. It's hard to put into words this feeling I have. We share a connection, something I never expected. A love so powerful and pure. Someday you'll feel it too. No matter where you go or where you find your place in this world, we will always have this connection.
Right, okay. Right, there's something else there. No, down, 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 down. There's more stuff here in the corners. Like, what is this?
Mum with me as a baby. I've never seen this. Hard to believe I was ever that small.
You can see the resemblance, can't you? It'd be helpful if we found a portrait of their, like, wedding. It might have a date on the back of it.
I don't have any memory of this. I wish I could remember doing this. Mum died too young.
With Amelia gone,
the manor is a different place.
A dimness pervades, a quiet I can't stand. Even though Lara is too young to understand what has happened, she also senses the change. She's asked after her mother only once, and I'm afraid my reaction must have terrified her. I will need Winston more than ever these next few months to help look after her. I never quite realized how much grief can consume a man, but I am utterly consumed. I know I can't escape the pain, but I will try my damnedest to avoid it. I will seal the West Wing for as long as I live in this place. It will remain exactly as Amelia left it. Perhaps someday Lara can find her own answers there.
Right, okay. So your wife leaves and you lock up an entire wing of the house. Okay. Right, the master bedroom. Might find a portrait of Blue in here.
After everything Atlas has done, how could you tell him about the expedition?
It's just all been too much. I needed to talk to someone. He's still my brother.
I think this was Dad's pocket watch. Looks like it stopped precisely at midnight.
I don't trust him.
That might be a reference to the film. Please, the Lara Croft film. Because it was
sorry, my dear, but I know him. He'll take it to the papers. The investors will pull out.
Then go. Without me. Tonight. I will take care of Atlas. And then meet you in Tibet next week.
I was so young, but I still remember that terrible argument. It wasn't always an easy road for my parents.
I believe it took this trip to push me over the edge. I've been able to see Richard in his element, seeing him at his best and his worst. I've experienced the purity and chaos of his passion, and I came to realize I want his passion in my life, every day. So it's done. Richard wanted to wait another 4 days until my birthday, but I wouldn't have it. Once I make a decision, I prefer to get on with it. So we found a small chapel in Luxor that was just right. And with Roth and the others at our side, we married as the sun set over this remarkable land. Mother will never forgive me.
Okay, oh, a wedding ring.
Mum's wedding ring. I always wondered what happened to it.
This, wait a minute.
The inscription is faded.
Oh, yeah. It's really, really hard to make out, but it's there. What does that say? I can't read it. Eternally yours, does that say? Damn it, it can't just have a date engraved on it. Would have made things so much easier. Portrait, anything I can use.
I am bursting with pride. Amelia is with child. It is amazing how everything in life can change with such a simple event. Obviously, we don't know the gender, but already we've discussed possible names. Perhaps Benjamin, after my grandfather? Or maybe Griffin? He was more infamous a Croft than even me. No, Amelia wouldn't have it. Besides, she's certain it's a girl. She favours a classic such as Scarlet or Kate, though I've made some headway with Lara. A subtle nod to the sun god Ra, and our days in Egypt where certainly this child was conceived. I find myself thinking about this new life we've created, of how much she might be like us. For all my research into myths of immortality, I may have ignored the most obvious answer to the questions that plague me. We live on through our progeny, our genes, DNA, experiences passed through the generations. Perhaps this is the simple truth of eternal life, and I've just been too stubborn to accept it.
Dad may have discovered the secret to immortality without even knowing it.
Right.
Mum, on her wedding day, she looks so beautiful.
There's October.
A date. October. Boom. Something. Damn, the number is faded. The anniversary was in October. But which day? I can't believe I don't know this. There's got to be another clue somewhere. I remember this. Dad gave it to Mum on her birthday.
Okay. October 13th. Birthday.
October 13th. Mum's birthday.
Is that a good date to start, isn't it?
I'm pretty sure my parents were married in October. I think it was close to her birthday. Okay, back to the study to open that safe.
Okay, so let me... Right, Sunday close. So, 5, 4, and... Okay, 13. 13, right. 10, let's try 9.
That worked.
Yes!
It makes me happy to know that Dad kept the safe.
Lara's handprint?
No, that's not what I'm looking for.
I am numb. It is taking all my willpower to hold back the overwhelming grief. Amelia's plane crashed in the mountains. She died alone in the snow, waiting for me to find her. Oh God, not her, not now. I cannot accept it. Life without her is too painful to imagine.
Oh boy.
I know what must be done. And I am resolved. I'm going to bring her back. Perhaps this is why I am here. Perhaps this is fate. A test of my faith in the truth I've sought for so long. Roth will fight me on this, but I can't face Lara. I can't look into her eyes unless I try. I must try to bring Amelia back. The monks are preparing the elixir now, and then we will see if all my years of hunting this truth was for naught.
Dad, what did you do?
What did he do?
Dad's sequel to his first book on immortality. He never got a chance to publish it. Handwritten. This is the only copy. Damn, this isn't it either. I was certain there had to be a will in here. Wait, what's that?
Please be it. Is this it?
A blank page.
Am I missing something here?
A hidden message.
Oh, okay.
What are these strange marks? They have to be some kind of clue.
What room in the house is this? What room in the house? Right, it's pointing to something here. Right. Let me get that puzzle back up.
A hidden message.
Okay, so one symbol and a number, so it'd be 1, 4. 1, 4.
A hidden message.
1, 4, 1, 4, 1, 4.
I remember
four,
this now. Two. Each district.
1, 4, 2. That's the message. Okay. Using the Using that hieroglyph worksheet, it's 1, 4, 2. 1, 4, 2. So that must be significant for something. 1, 4, 2. We're getting some of this.
The Croft family crest.
1, 4, 2. 1, 4, 2. 1, 4, 2. 1, 4, 2. What room? Could it be a room number? I think what it was talking about was down here. 1, 4, 2. Closer look, that's the family dining table. Pointing here, right, 1, 2, 1, 1, 4, 2. Got it.
Locked in.
Okay. Alright. But anyway, guys, this has been OggiEx playing Rise of the Tomb Raider. I'm going to stop and break this down into parts because there is just so much to cover now with this game. Because there's multiple DLCs, multiple modes and stuff like that now. A lot of really fun stuff to play. So I'm going to get around to playing it all at some point or another, but I will be breaking it down into parts. But anyway, if you did enjoy the video, please do remember to leave it a like, and why not subscribe for more Rise of the Tomb Raider when it comes out, along with other really cool videos on the channel, and I will see you in the next one. Until then, bye-bye. Damn, it's so good to have this game back. Oh, shit. Yeah, this is a bit of a throwback for Obi, when he got hit in the face by a rock elemental. Next time Obi goes over towards that thing, shrink the barrier down.
You ready?
Yeah, go and shrink the barrier.
Shrink the barrier. Where is it?
Why is he turning around? Oh god.